Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension. And this is another one of my question and answer videos, you know, and this is mainly focused on Draco cord cutting. These are the answers, you know, I give to the comments, to the public comments, you know, in my Draco cord cutting video. So I will answer those, and then I will move on to other videos, or just, you know, also answer, you know, direct questions at me, you know, in this forum here. All right, so this is from Fished Till Here, and when I try to listen to any of your cord cutting meditations, I always fall asleep and wake up at 16:45. It's quite odd. We'll have to try again. And so this happens to quite a lot of people, and even to myself sometimes, you know, when I listen to my own meditation, you know, this, you know, you are gone. And, you know, sometimes, you know, we are just stressed out. And, you know, when we come to a quiet place, you know, the subtle body leaves the body and just refreshes. You know, also when your vibration goes up, you know, you become more accessible to your own spirit guides, and so they work on you. And plus, it's also interesting to see, you know, what I was doing there at this time when you always pass out. I mean, I checked it out, and I think it's like when my introduction was over and the real meditation starts, that's when you wake up. So maybe your high self was not interested in my small talk. You know, but there may be other reasons, you know, where you go under and where you don't. You know, just investigate that for yourself. Now, this is from Anne Marshmallowberg. This sounds as if somebody makes fun of Jewish names, like Gold and Rosenberg. So, this is essay. Did this meditation, you know, Draco cord cutting. I felt like my core, my body was vibrating side to side. I thought I was going to levitate. Ooh. I had my back behind my solar plexus get hot. And I know that this worked and it is awesome. Thank you so much for your feedback and coming forward. And sorry, I'm really not trying to make fun of you. You know, I'm trying to be funny as entertainment, but I'm not trying to make fun of you. All right, so I apologize. You know, your body was vibrating side to side. So vibration is kind of an on and off of a muscle. And this on and off kind of is part of a, you know, relaxation, you can say. You know, it relaxes. You know, I have, there's the, I think, M10, which is like a pulse machine, you know, that's used by acupuncturist sometimes, also, you know, by other people, you know, with electrodes, which gives you certain shock patterns, you know, at certain voltages. You know, I have a version of this, and, you know, you get little electroshocks, you know, which stimulate your nerves, and your muscle goes on and off, on and off, on and off. And, you know, it helps to relax a muscle that has deep tension. There is also the techniques, and this is just about the muscle relaxation, you know, where you, like, you have a tense back, you just really tense it really more, and then you let go. And you probably have a deeper relaxation, you know, as if you just would have tried to, you know, relax it, maybe do it again. Just tense your shoulders as much as you can, and then let go. Ooh, this feels nice. Right, so this kind of vibration, you know, back and forth, you know, can, you know, shake things loose. You know, also this is a result, and this is more likely in this case, when a higher energy, you know, shoots through your body. Let's say, you know, the Kundalini awakens, you know, or say, you know, you touch an electric fence, you know, your body starts to shake. So, you know, high energy states, you know, your body starts to shake too. So this is quite likely, you know, that in this clearing, you know, put you into a high energy state, you know, suddenly all the sucking gets disconnected from you, and suddenly you have, you know, your system runs on 200% more energy, and it's not used to it, and it start kind of shaking, you know. It's a little much, you know, for what you're used to. But then, you know, you get accustomed to it, you know, and of course with this kind of higher energy, you're probably also going to detox more and should drink a lot of water for that reason. You know, higher energy always goes together with detoxing, you know. Okay, and so you had this feeling of, you know, going to levitate. You know, this is a wonderful feeling, and so, you know, this is kind of a divine feeling, you know, which leads to euphoria, right? So the feeling of zero G or weightlessness is associated with euphoria, you know, and like when you have a trampoline and you come to the apex where you have zero G, you know, it creates euphoria. You know, the same is with the jumping of the Hare Krishna in ecstasy, when it's just bing, 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 you know, it creates euphoria. And it's, of course, you have to be in a very high energy state, you know, to experience this. You know, and I'm pretty sure that's the same, you know, this TM, you know, when they start hopping around. You know, you just really, you know, plugged in when you do this. And so, you know, that's about the feeling of levitation. And, you know, it's also, you know, this lightness that comes over you, you know, when like a lot of pressure and cords, you know, release from you, you know, you also feel this lightness, you know, feel floating. And sometimes it's even, you know, your head goes back and you have the feeling as if something is leaving you. That's a good thing. You know, all these are kind of, you know, associated with the feeling of levitation. And then, you know, your back, you know, where your solar plexus is, got hot. Now, the solar plexus area is kind of the area of consciousness that is, you could say, social consciousness. You know, you're standing in the group, you know, whether it's family or tribe or state, you know, or business world, you know, it's those kind of power issues. And it's, you know, also the focus of your willpower, and there's a lot of energy available there. And there, you know, the solar plexus chakra, you know, the energy center that is associated with this big nerve complex there. You know, nerve always, you know, deal with electricity, and electricity always, you know, affects the electromagnetic realm, right? And so on the electromagnetic realm, you know, you're having like what's considered, you know, an energy swirling around from all the nervous activity. Mm-hmm. So, breathing, forward and backwards. So forward is the world that you are aware of, you know, that you manipulate maybe with your desire, with your will, you know, trying to force somebody, you know. But the back, that's your subconscious. And according to, I think her name is Brandman, Hands of Light, you know, it is also connected with your career, you know, how you respond in your work, you know, how do you, you know, relate to your work environment as such, you know, do you fit in where you work, do you stick out, you know, are you happy, you know, are you unhappy? So, but this is all power, it's more the subconscious power, you know, to the back are all these subconscious, you know, chakras that you're not aware of. Mm-hmm. And so Alpha Draconians definitely, you know, draw energy, you know, from humans. Not the way Matrix shows it. In the Matrix, you know, you see like a high-tech container, and you know there are metallic, you know, suctions, you know, attached to the spine. The cords, you know, the etheric cords of the Alpha Draconian, more like, all right, you know, you have chewing gum. Here, you know, it's chewing gum on the pavement, it's in the sun, nice and soft, you know, you stick on, you know, you step on it and then you pull it, and so, you know, the chewing gum kind of draws, right, and you have like a lot here and then it gets smaller, you know, and then you have maybe several strands, you know, till don't disconnect. So this is kind of how, you know, those cords look, but they can get really fat and thick and have some pretty nasty feelings through them. The Draconians, they just harvest your energy, you know, they draw your energy, you know, from you. It's just like humans, you know, draw milk from the udder of a cow. You know, we don't think anything bad about it. And probably the Alpha Draconians don't think anything bad about it either. But that's just how they do things, right? Like humans eat pigs, you know, they don't, you know, necessarily, you know, think bad about it, right? So same way. So probably, you know, this got disconnected and then it got activated. You know, so, you know, suddenly, you know, the energy doesn't get sucked out anymore and, ooh, you know, suddenly there is more chi there and, you know, more chi means ha, as most people. So that's probably what happened, you know, and yes, you know, it worked and it's awesome. And private sessions are even more awesome, I have to say. This is just a shotgun meditation. All right, thank you. And now here, this is Sun Bu, and again about the video Draco cord cutting comment. And I would like to know, how about energetic sex? Does it have the same effect on cording, like with the body? All right. So energetic sex. I would say that yes, you know, maybe not at the same degree. And now also, is it like, is it welcome? Is it reciprocal? Yeah, you know, is you know, the advancement answered, you know, or is it predatory? You know, you just latch on to that poor lady or that nice man and, you know, just take the beauty and suck them dry, you know, which is really not good karma, you know. If you think I'm giving you a good idea, no. There are a lot of grandmothers and other protectors that get quite upset when you start doing this, and they might just retaliate, you know, so it's not a good idea to do so. So, I would say yes, subtle sex, you know, does cordings, and pretty much any intense experience, you know, does cordings, you know, intense in a good way or intense in a bad way, you know, there are cords there. And so that while, you know, there has to be a forgiveness, you know, if there was offense, you know, if there's no forgiveness, you might even get stuck with that person through courts, you know, through lifetimes. And then there's a lot of magic also around courts, you know, where, you know, that's a predatory thing. So it's a big subject and quite complicated to do by yourself. I advise, you know, to take private sessions for that, you know. But it's not something to be completely fearful about, you know. It's not going to get worse, you know. You're probably at your worst right now, and whatever you learn about it and learn how to deal with it, it's going to get better from now on, right? It's like, you know, you learn how, you suddenly discover you can brush your teeth and how nice it feels, you know. So it's going to get better from then on, you know. Maybe then sooner you can floss too, that is even better, you know, something like that. Right, and there's another one from Sanbu, and hello Wolfgang, how about the Anunnaki? What's the best way to get rid of them, and what can you tell us about them? Okay, well, let me see if I'm gonna go further here. I know one, and he claims to be a light being, but I sure don't believe him. For some reason, he is very interested in me. I'm not sure what he or some of us have. Oh, you know, there is no punctuation here. It's not that I don't know how to read. I think Sanbu, you know, has Mr. Fatfinger interfering, you know, when he's typing on the phone. So, okay, so there's also what he, some of us have Anunnaki incarnations, and they are working and experiencing through us. Yes, actually, this is a very good question and a very good observation. And I have to say, you know, I'm running into all kinds of really foul experiences, you know, with my clients and through Anunnaki. And I was definitely also incarnated with them. And they have quite a history here, and they are incarnating here as in human bodies. And there are, I would say, good ones and there are bad ones. You know, it's just like humans or people of New York. You know, you can't say all New Yorkers are rude or bad or good, you know, creative, you know. No, there are all kinds of things, right? And sorry, I don't want to offend anybody. Nothing wrong with New Yorkers and New York. It's a very high energy place. Those Herkimer diamonds. Anyhow, so Anunnakis incarnate, and I have seen some of those, you know, really suffer in the human form. You know, they go to the lowest, most severe victim modes, abuse, you know, and so their experience, you know, the lowest of, you know, of what you can experience as a human being, you know. And in a way, you know, you could interpret this as like, you know, the cook has to eat his own soup. You know, it's like a karma thing. But also, you know, I would say it's like the CEO, you know, volunteers, you know, to work with the lowest worker, you know, cleaning the toilets in his own company, you know, so he can say, you know, yeah, you know, I've worked, you know, or work every job in his own company, you know, so he can say, you know, I have the right, you know, to rule here, you know, I have experienced it all, you know, I'm not an armchair philosopher, or I'm not facing up to my karma. And some of those Anunnaki gods and goddesses, especially the goddesses, you know, they were just in tears and, you know, very disturbed of what happened to their good plans, to their good ideas and wishes, you know, how it all kind of went to pieces, how it got spoiled, you know, how things happened that were unforeseen, and, you know, the suffering of, you know, their priests and priestesses that they encountered. You know, they see them as children or pets in a way, you know, like you love a pet. You know, I mean, they're so much smarter than you in your human form, you know, you have to understand. So intellectually, you know, they have concepts you have no idea, you know, they run complete circles around you, right? And so, but, you know, still, their experience, you know, every aspect, I think, of humanity is experienced by, you know, those beings too. And they're probably aware of their flaws, very much so, and resentful of, you know, of what they did, of, you know, of their own deeds. But probably also, you know, they want to keep ruling, you know, they think that this earth belongs to them, and there are also different kind of groups of them. Yes. I hope, let me see what else we have here. So, and so he claims to be a light being. Okay, so, yes. Now, there has been a lot of interaction of Anunnaki, you know, or let's say gods, let's say, you know, the demigods, right? And humans, you know, especially in the past times. And just like, you know, in the old legends, you know, the Olympic legends or whatever, you know, there has been deceit, you know, many contracts, you know, between, you know, those gods and the humans, you know, were misleading and, you know, basically, you know, exploiting the human energies throughout incarnations, you know, sucking, harvesting the energies, but not delivering what was promised. Those things happen quite a lot, you know. And so, yeah, and there was also sometimes, you know, deliberately, you know, wrong information given by certain, you know, gods to their priests or priestesses, you know, because they didn't like, you know, the influence, the power they got, you know. So they were set up or thrown, humans were set up by their gods that they worshipped and served as priests, as channels, you know. They were set up and thrown under the bus, so this has happened too. And I would say, you know, some of them I like and I respect. And some of them are just, you know, very human and, you know, not necessary to be trusted. It's like, you know, when you're a dog, you know, how many humans can you really trust? And those humans are not necessarily bad, you know, but as a dog, many dogs get just let out by the curb, you know, and just get abandoned or abused, right? So the same with the Anunnaki. And so, you know, the how to get around it, you know, it's very complicated, very difficult to do by yourself, I would say. And, you know, also you know, one has to be very careful not to be offensive, you know. You know, they're not something to be joked around with, but you can take shelter, you know, in Source, in God. You know, an Archangel Michael, you know, the archangels, you know, they definitely rule over the gods, you know, and Source, definitely, you know. You know, appeal, you know, to absolute Source, you know, and the representations, whatever this is, you know, and you should get protection. But this is not a one prayer, you know, and you're done thing, process, you know. I hope this helps. Okay, and yeah, so, you know, this is, I'm basically, you know, verifying what you said. Very, very good question. And this is from The Alchemist, again, a comment to Draco Cord-Cutting. Hello, Wolfgang, I would like to ask a question. I don't talk about this often, as it was very disturbing for me to even mention, but I feel like the universe sent me your video for this reason. My ego already loves you. So a few years ago, I was napping in my bed. It was a light nap, half asleep, half awake, when I noticed a being or entity astrally enter my room by materializing or phasing through my closet, you know, doors of a closet. And I have to say, you know, I had this experience, you know, waking up from a dream, you know, being in the half-between state, And there was an entity standing at the end of my bed, you know, and this was an old pleasure castle, you know, of the aristocracy in France, and I'm sure they did black magic there, you know, all kinds of heavy stuff. That place was haunted, and that wasn't a human either that was standing there. So just to let you know that similar stuff has happened. And so it was phasing in, you know, very well. So this entity had taken the form of my mother, probably as camouflage, yes. Mothers don't phase in, very good. But even through my sleepy haze, I could tell it wasn't really her due to the fact that it was my mother from my childhood and this creepy, unnatural grin she had on her face. So yeah, good instincts, you know, and even, you know, half dozed, you know, you picked up, you know, there was something off. You know, sometimes this even happens, you know, you're in the middle of the nightmare and then you're like, hey, this isn't right, I'm in a nightmare, you know, and then you just asked for help and you're popping out. So okay, so you notice this, very good. And as I noticed this intruder, I instinctively lunged toward it or her. And before it retreated, it shot me in the sacrum, root chakra area, with the, what appeared to be a small silver digital camera. All right, so, you launched at this thing. I mean, this is awesome. You know, this is the first time, you know, I hear somebody, you know, that attacks, you know, an intrusion like this. I mean, you know, people that curl up and start sucking their thumb, you know, and freeze in fear, you know, but you launch at it, you know, you are some kind of heavy-duty warrior, all right? You know, that this is not usual. That you launch into an intrusion, you know, something where normal humans just get scared, pale, all right? So, and it shot something like it seems like a maybe astral, you know, this is on the astral plane, so, but it put an astral object into your sacrum, and, you know, still awake, you know, you were kicking in pain. Oh yeah, so let me just read. And then fully woke up, kicking my legs in pain. A week later, I started developing a pilonical cyst in the butt crack area where I have been shot. I managed to treat and heal this with a medieval homeopathic remedy, a compress of garlic and onion. Well, that's definitely very detoxing, and the sulfur is actually the active ingredient, you know, next time just use sulfur. And it rained for 2 weeks before finally healing. It left a scar though, yeah, so you know, this was definitely something very, very toxic. Maybe you could have also applied charcoal, activated charcoal or bentonite, you know, it detoxes on the physical chemical plane. And I probably also would have tried, let's say, like a Clorox bath, you know, Clorox, but you got to be careful that you're not allergic, you know, and but it can also really purify, you know, some of this dark stuff, you know, you can maybe even kick a flu with it. So, but now this year I would have tried that. So yeah, so you definitely have some trauma there, you know, that's still there. Otherwise, you know, if you completely remove the scar, you know, chances are that, you know, scars disappear. So what was this? You know, was this a psychic attack? Was this a baked chakra implant? Yeah, both of them, you know. You know, I mean, instead of like a camera kind of a device, which was probably a tech thing, you know, you could just also like Tai Chi vice, like, you know, throw an energy ball into you, you know, of anger or something like this, you know. So, but that seemed to be tech. It was tech, you know, and that wasn't from a loving being either. You know, loving beings don't, you know, hurt, you know, like a really telepathic being, you know, an advanced being would have just stopped you with his mind, you know, sent you a cloud of love, you chill out, you know, or just freeze you, you know. There are, let's say, back doors, you know, into your subconscious, you know, that many ETs can access to control you. And, but maybe you're such a warrior, you know, that you couldn't do this. You know, so it just whacked you with the seal. So, you have tried many implant removal meditations, one for my channel as well. But I didn't know they have worked given how physical it all felt. And since these implants tend to be more energetic, I just don't know, right? You just don't know. So I think this affected my physical energy levels, you know, always tired. And my sexual nature as well. I used to be way more sexual. Well, you know, sexuality, libido is very, very strongly related to your life force, right? So if your root chakra is blocked or, you know, it gets sucked, then, you know, you won't have much libido, you know, and you won't have much life force either. So, let's say the Alpha Draconians, you know, with their weapons, and this has been, you know, even with their old tech thousands of years ago at the Battle of Kurukshetra and other places like the Ramayana, you know, they were called Rakshasas in the Vedic scriptures. I found when I was working with, you know, past life regression with those people that got hit with Alpha Draconian or Rakshasa weapons, they all caught it. You know, they're corded, the wound is corded through to the Draco throughout space and time, and they, you know, download you or suck energy from you, you know, send information to manipulate you. It's like having you on a leash through which they can pump stuff into you or draw stuff out of you, you know. So this thing could just be a block that would be kind of more low-tech, or it could be like, you know, higher-tech, you know, like Draco technology or higher, where there is a cording, you know, so we like on a harpoon, you know, with a string on it, so you can't get away, you know, through space and time. And, you know, the same thing, you know, for your sexual energy, which is actually something more digested, you know. And so then he gives us proof, you know, that he doesn't have much of a sex drive anymore. And I don't get into the detail here. But I can tell you one thing, you know, you can see how much sex drive you have when you look at this part of your thumb. You know, it's called in palmistry the Venus Hill. And, you know, if this is nice and juicy, you know, your libido is high. And if it's like all shrinkly and, you know, your libido is low, right? And so any help would be appreciated, truly. Well, you can book a private session. This is kind of what I do. If you get through to your high self, I probably can help you. And so I leave my comment here in the open so that anyone else going through a similar issue may find solace and answer. So I really, first of all, appreciate, you know, you sharing. This is definitely, you know, very intimate stuff, and, you know, it takes a lot of guts, you know, to come forward with this, and, you know, I appreciate that, and it's probably a lot of good karma, you know, for everybody that you help through this, right? And, you know, this whole stealing of life force, you know, is definitely a big thing. But this is with everybody, you know, pretty much everybody gets harvested by the Alpha Draconian. You know, you, you know, probably got an extra thing in there, you know. And you can check with yourself, you know, with a pendulum, you know, let's say originally, you know, you had 100% of this thing in there, and now how much is still left, you know. And you know, you can answer a lot of those questions probably with the pendulum. Otherwise, I would say, you know, get a private session. I hope this helps. All right, now this is Kiriana Pekin, and this is also a comment regarding Draco cord cutting. And thank you, namaste. I always look forward to your videos. Thank you. And they're very freeing and thoroughly healing. Thank you. Much love and light always. Okay, our daughter who has multiple disabilities, and I use them regularly, and I share them often. Her favorite is sending love to Mother Gaia. And so your daughter, you know, her favorite is sending love to the Earth Mother. So she's an indigo child. You know, she's an indigo child. You know, she came here to heal Mother Gaia. So, just send her a lot of love, and I love her. And learn how to communicate. You know, with you know your daughter's high self. I would say this would be very, you know, fantastic. You know, open your crown chakra and, you know, do the inner child work with her, you know, as if your daughter is your inner child, you know. That would be very, very rewarding for you. And your daughter probably has an awful heart chakra too. If you want some guidance, you know, just contact me and glad to help you. Namaste. Yeah, there's so many light beings here, you know. It's dangerous to come in here, incarnate. You know, there are so many toxins and cell phone radiation, you know. Just for a pregnant mother to have a cell phone and, you know, on your body, it's very bad. You know, you better inform yourself. You know, any pregnant women, you know, if you don't care for yourself, you know, care for your child that's coming in, you know, so it doesn't get screwed up. You know, just go on YouTube and research cell phone radiation by yourself. So, you know, your child has all the opportunities, you know, it needs to fulfill its mission in this lifetime, okay? So this is another question or comment from Amanda Nash regarding Draco cord cutting. And she says, this is the third time I'm doing this meditation in the last week. So powerful, especially if you are at a transition point. Thank you for this, Wolfgang. You were one of the first YouTube guides I was led to. I can definitely feel the difference in the way your videos feel to me after several years of spiritual work. Well, first of all, thank you so much for your positive feedback, and I hope I was a good influence in your life. And I mean, of course, you know, there are two things happening. You know, of course, I evolved too. You know, my horizon, you know, also has widened tremendously, you know. Coming from the rays of the vibration on this planet in general, as well as, you know, personal work, as well as, you know, I talk to so many high selves and spirit guides of my clients, and, you know, and so, you know, the experiences, you know, widen my horizon, you know, of what is reality. And so I evolve too, I clear more, I constantly clear, you know, and try to improve. And so my potency increases, you know, the way that God can work through me or my high self can work through me. You know. I'm just kind of learning to step aside more and more, I have to say, you know, the dissolution of the ego, you know, then experiencing the ecstasy of, you know, divinity, you know, is working through you. It's wonderful. So that in me increased, you know, and so the contact high, you know, you're getting from, you know, just watching me and listening to me, you know, it's getting stronger. So, you know, that's just resonance, you know, or the Hindus call this darshan, you know, having darshan with somebody. And but then on the other hand also, you know, my videos are very multi-layered. You know, there is a lot of information, you know, very packed closely together. You know, I don't spend half an hour just, you know, going over one idea. You know, this is very densely layered. And many of those things, you know, you will only understand once you have experienced it. So, you know, and then, you know, oh yeah, this is what he's talking about, you know, and you can, and some of those things, because you have experienced, you know, lesser things before, you know, you have the faith and understanding, yeah, this is also possible. You know, it's just a projection of what you already experienced, you know, how your mind has been blown before. So going over the same thing again, you know, after some time, you know, you will see different issues, you know, and again, also your own karma and spiritual evolution, it's like an onion, you know. You know, you have the outer layer, and then you peel, and then you got another issue to another aspect. And like, you know, your love life, and then career, and then relationships, and then, you know, ghost, and then finance, and then love life, another layer of love life, you know, and to just keep peeling away. You know, and if that all would happen at the same time, you know, it would just be way too harsh. You wouldn't be the same person anymore, right? They might as well erase your mind with electroshocks and LSD and just reprogram you. Nothing left of the old personality, right? So, you know, yeah, it's good observation. So, yeah, just keep going, you know, over, you know, your old stuff. And I love you, namaste. Now this is a comment from Girls Like Fairies, Draco Court Clearing video. Glad to have found your channel. Open to receiving all your healings and clearings. I'm honored to receive them. I've had a lot of implants in my sacral chakra and heart chakra. Feel a lot of painful stuck energies, and the meditation makes me feel like energies are moving, and I have a lot of pulsation and pumping up and strong movements in my sacral chakra. Just first of all, you know, before I forget, so sacral chakra is like major, you know, place for implantation. You know, it's just, you know, every time we had sex or had good sex, you know, or the other guy had good sex, there is a cording, you know, and then that moment of glory is often revisited, and, you know, even cords that have been once detached get reattached, right? And because, you know, sex is also such an intense experience for many, you know, with any intense experience there is cording. So automatically, you know, with, you know, sex comes cording to the sacral area. You know, if you have a lot of sex, you had a lot of good sex with different people, you're going to have a lot of cordings there, you know, and you're going to be cherished memories in many people's minds too. But, you know, it comes together with losing energy, so you would have to do cord clearing, you know, quite often. It's like, you know, brushing your teeth. You know, you do this pretty much daily. So, and, you know, so pulsating, you know, I call it more wave, but, you know, release comes so many times in waves. You know, I feel it in waves that just float over you, and generally, yes, the release is upwards. You know, and why upwards? Well, my personal explanation is it resonates, it goes with your chakra system, you know. So the lower chakras represents more the dense, you know, reality of consciousness, you know, the survival, the duality of, you know, any the duality world, that would be into the sexual chakra, the second chakra, and then, you know, it just keeps evolving more and more to more and more cosmic, you know, crown chakra be the, or crown chakras be the most cosmic. And well, where am I going here? I'm going to the crown chakra and I get spaced out. So, pulsation, yeah. So, so the energy, you know, goes to higher and higher and higher and higher consciousness, right? And then it dissipates, you know, it has been transmuted, you know, into the higher energy. You know, this happens with ghosts, this happens with energy that are being cleared. You know, this is, you know, one way, you know, I experience a lot of clearing with my clients. Mm-hmm. So, that about the pulsating movements, yes. And you can actually support this, you know, if in you're awake, you know, with your hand movements. Let's say, you know, you can use your hands, you know, to clear out your crown chakra or to fluff away, you know, stuff that's stuck, you know, in your neck or in your forehead, you know, or on your side, you know, or on your shoulders, just brush it off, you know, and the more you chill up, you know, the more, you know, chi you're running through your fingers and hands, you know, the more effective is this cleansing, right? So, I can't wait to get rid of these stuck energies forever, yeah. Yeah, that is very good. Good idea. So I know my emotional issues and shadows were given access to these parasites. Yes, this is absolutely correct. First of all, you know, let's say traumatic issues, you know, whether they're like from an axe or from an emotion, they go somewhere, like anger goes to the liver, you know. Of course, an axe blow to the shoulder, yeah, that's not an axe blow to the shoulder. But then the shoulder somehow is a weak spot in the force field, also in further incarnation, and chances are that then arrows and other things happen to the shoulder area. Maybe it breaks, you know, maybe a horse kicks there in another incarnation. You know, so I find that generally wounds, you know, or trauma piles up in the same areas, incarnation after incarnation. You know, there seems to be like something energetic, you know, going on there, you know, like attracts like. So, and similar also, you know, so these dark spots in the force field can be seen. Many people, many of my clients can see it, especially when we ask to be shown, you know, or you can feel it, you know, when you sense into it, like, ugh, yeah, this feels bad, you know, something like that. There's an icky feeling, you know, something like that. So, yeah, or, you know, there's an emotional, yeah, response, you know. So there are several ways, you know, you can feel those. And so this is where, you know, especially parasites like rat, you know, they're astral rats or something like archons attached or ghosts attached to those two, or get into those traumas, you know. They need like low vibration, you know. If there's nothing of low vibration onto you, you become like Teflon to them, you know. Nothing, they can't touch you, you know. There's nothing they like, you know. It's like, no, this is too high vibration for me, you know, I don't like it, right? So yes, they're attached to your darkness. But I'm learning the lesson of forgiveness and unconditional love and sympathy for other humans, because it's only because of unconscious living that people hurt each other. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, if they would really know what happens when they hurt somebody, you know, how this ripples throughout incarnations and how it screws up everything, yeah, if they would know that, they wouldn't do it. You know, they would not do that, you know. It's just like, in hindsight, you know, it's just like everybody gets hurt, you know, when you hurt each other, you know. In one incarnation, you know, you hurt, you know, your brother, and then in the next, you know, he's your father or your boss and just screws you over, and then in the next you screw him over in another role, and it just keeps going back and forth. I mean, I see this all the time, you know. I'm just like in a Jerry Springer show where I have to like pacify fights. You know, in with past life relationships, etc. So, if another person could see your energetic body and emotional body, they would never hurt you. So, but people are supposed to live in love and harmony with each other. I mean, I completely agree with this, you know. Everyone will be each other's twin flame and have unconditional love for each other. Well, no, twin flame is kind of a special position. It's like I'm gonna rock your boat kind of a thing, you know. Generally, it is... So right now in humanity, we have a lot of transition, you know, but I would say in future humanity, like in Mount Shastra, you know, there are... there is an underground, you know, higher vibrational humanoid colony, you know, and those people, you know, they're the whole family is just from one soul, you know, so they're all, you could say, yeah, what is this? Soulmates, they're all soulmates, you know. But this with us humans right now, you know, we're finishing up, you know, a lot of karma that we have maybe with soul group, people from our soul group, not from our own soul. You know, soulmate means, you know, from your own soul. No, or other, from other souls, you know, we have karma and maybe, you know, stuff to learn. And so, you know, we're not here to enjoy, you know, the bliss of having a whole... soulmate family, you know, where you and your wife and your children, you know, are all from the same soul, you know. No, we're here for other work, all right? So these dark forces use our negative emotions to their advantage and drain your energy, our energy. Yes, absolutely. Actually, they love your dark emotions. It is so important to heal and forgive everyone who has wronged you. Mm-hmm. So, to see their shortcomings and forgive them for not being able to live up to your expectations. Well, I tell you what, you know, after all, seeing those thousands and thousands of lifetimes, we've pretty much done everything, you know, that we hate in others too. You know, it's very rare that there is somebody that didn't do bad stuff. That's very, very, very rare, you know. So if you think you have been, you know, pure love and light in all your lifetimes, you know, that's either spiritual ignorance or spiritual pride, you know, or being completely naive, you know. And, you know, we probably all have walked on the dark side and on the light side, all right? So anyhow, but this, you know, knowing this, that you have done it all yourself, you know, gives you humility and also gives you, you know, absolute forgiveness, you know. When you know that most likely, you know, what is being done to you, did you others, you know, then you know, oh, that's how that felt to the other person when I did it to them, you know. Just ask, you know, whatever, you know, is being done to you when you're a victim. Just ask your high self, use the pendulum or whatever you trust, kinesiology, whether you did this to somebody else. You know, you might be amazed. Okay. So back to you here. So once you are in charge of your soul and body and energy, you will experience what you want and everything will be fine. Because your frequency will have risen enough. Well, that's a little high expectation, but it's going to get better. So I've learned some really hard lessons about forgiveness and unconditional love and non-attachment and non-expectation. You should rather go deep in your connection with the divine. Absolutely agree. That's a must if you want high vibration and happiness and peace. Yes, I completely agree, you know, very good, you know, very, very nice, and thank you so much for sharing. And this is from The Watcher, and this is from a video, you know, while Smile, and he writes, and this is kind of why I smile like an idiot, right, but, you know, it's, That's just the extreme of smiling. So what would you suggest a person do when they want to be happy and stay in the positive? But my husband is probably, I would say, 90% negative nowadays. I can't stand it. Well, yeah, so that is definitely, you know, a difficult situation. You know, the question is, you know, is this, you know, changeable, is it transmutable, you know, or not the negativity of your husband, right? So that is the question, you know. If he's not going to change, you know, for the rest of his life, if there's no hope, you know, could you live like that? You know, how would it affect you? You know, difficult, very, very difficult question. You know, would I want to have responsibility, you know, for saying do this or do that? No. But what can be done here? You know, what can be done? So the question is, you know, why is your husband so negative, right? And generally, you know, several reasons, you know, the standard stuff. There are vows, you know, maybe sometimes out of guilt, you know, most of the stuff is from past lifetimes. You know, there are curses, and that's in general the majority. There is karma, you know, where you basically, you know, get payback, you know, for what you dished out, it's coming back to you, you know. And there are ghosts, you know, so ghosts and soul fragments. This is to do with past lifetimes in many cases, sometimes also ghosts from the present or, you know, ghosts from ancestors. You know, this is like one big area that most people are not so aware of, that's not dealt much with in many, you know, religions or spiritual traditions. And that has been kind of ridiculed a lot in the mainstream media. You know, these are very, very, you know, influential things. You know, there are so many relationships being spoiled by jealous past lover ghosts, you know, or by jealous pious ghosts from the past, you know, old nuns and renunciants, you know, that thing that sex is bad, or you make more spiritual advancement when you're by yourself, you know, old, very old-fashioned ideas that have nothing to do with this lifetime. Difficult to do ghost by yourself the first time, you know, try my meditation on it. But otherwise, I would say, you know, for the first time it's good, you know, if I do it with you, you know, once you have experienced it, you know how it feels like, and it's likely you can do it by yourself. All right. So that's it for today. You know, I love you, and as always, and send me more questions. I'm available for private sessions. You know, a lot of people kind of feel they're very weird, or I think they're crazy, or they blow my mind. I like to see that. So, you know, in many cases I can help. You know, it's worth a shot. Watch my other videos, subscribe, ring the bell, smile, breathe like a balloon. Namaste.